Jesse's seen enough evidence to know that energy has been detected. Energy that's flowing into neighborhoods and beyond. And the government has the power to control it.
Well, this is obviously, like they say, a person of interest. What we got here is an object of interest.
Armed with this new evidence, the team regroups to nail the forces behind the conspiracy.
I found the guy we got to talk to. Mark Phillips.
He's got all the answers to this?
He's going to lead us to the guy who does, the big kahuna.
Really?
Mark Phillips. A former CIA operative. He worked with the infamous MKUltra mind control program. Now, he stepped forward to fill in the blanks.
So, when MKUltra came to the forefront and it became public knowledge...
In the 70s.
In the 70s, the government said they canned the program, it was gotten rid of, and you're chuckling over that. Is that untrue?
Well...
Did they get rid of the mind control program, or did they just rename it and take it somewhere else?
It was a shell game. They just simply moved it from one agency to another. As it became more privatized, going into technologies at that time, they had a procedure where they actually put a transmitter, transceiver in your sinus cavity, and it was hardwired into your brain.
What would they use today in substitution for that?
Microwaves.
MK Ultra, microwaves. This could be the explanation for these people's symptoms.
So they actually send things through the airwaves?
Yes, they can.
And they can target one individual with this? They have the ability to do that?
Well, yes, and they also have the ability to do mass populations.
They have the ability to do that?
Well, there's a variety of answers, and all of them go back to the same thing, electromagnetic pulse.
The electromagnetic pulse. Streamed from a microwave tower, it can mimic human brain waves, create anxiety and pain in people, and create human speech inside their heads.